is that?
La Calunia. If you like us some more, you're going to have to pay me. I'm sorry. I am the Count Marco Polo, D13, Junior.
Junior?
Yes. I have come back from a triumphant tour of all of Italy. From Canale Stretta to Houston Street, they all love me a bella voce.
Are you going to do something, or what?
Yes, I will do something for you. But it's a funny thing you asked me about that, because I got a long story to tell you.
Maybe next time.
And it goes a lot of these. So once upon a time, there was a guy, his name was Marco Polo. And he said to his friend, Vinnie Martucci, hey, Vinnie, I don't know what, but I feel like eating something different tonight. You know what I mean? And Vinny, he said to Marco, I know what you mean. I know a good place to manja, and you just gotta follow me. So these are two guys, they started walking. And they started walking like this. And like this. And they ended up in a good Chinese restaurant, 5,000 miles away from Roma. And Mr. Big, I wonder if you can guess where they was after. If that starts with the bigger C, that's all right, that's all right. So these two guys, they was real hungry when they got to the restaurant. They sat down and said, waiter, the menu please. And Marco here looked down his menu, he said, give me everything from a column A. And Vinny, he looked on his menu and he said, I like everything from column B. And don't you forget the fortune cookies and the extra dark salsa. So then these are two guys, they was eating up a storm. They had the egg of young. They had all the dim sum they could eat. When all of a sudden, there was a woman screaming from the kitchen. And then Marco Polo said, he stood up, he said, hey, I'm a vegetarian. I don't eat dog or cat food. And Vinny, he looked up and he said, I think that the cat is in heat, because Vinny was what you call bisexual, you know what I mean? So then Marco Polo, he stood up again, he put down his chopsticks, and he said, hey, honey, don't you worry, I'm gonna come to rescue you. So he ran into the kitchen like this. And he said, don't you worry, I'm gonna put out the fire. And he picked up some olive oil that he uses to slick the back of his hair, and he threw it on that Peking duck. And this woman, this very nice, beautiful woman, she was a my grandmama. She was so grateful to Marco Polo. She said, hey Marco, thank you, grazie. Hey, did anybody tell you, you look like my favorite movie star, Sly Ballone? Oh, I just love his movie, Rocky, Roman Numo, Exa. So then, my grandmother said, oh, Mr. Marco Polo, you must come over to my house and try out my secret sauce. So then there was a wham, a bama, a grazia mama, and that Marco Polo, he went back a very happy fella. Because he had my grazie. Thank you very much. My grandmama's secret sauce. And he opened up the very first restaurant in all of Italy. And my great, great. Great-grandmama, she only had fond memories of Marco Polo's great Italiana sausage. And then 2 years later, she had a bambino. And then a couple of hundred years later, there was a me to inherit my grandfather's pepperoni sausage. Ah, very, very.
The bone.
Songs. Hey, I sang for all the queens in the Greenwich Village.
I bet you did.
But let me see something here. And how much are you talking about there for money?
I'm talking about the two bills and all the lox and bagels you can eat.
Hey, that sounds pretty good to me. You got a deal there, Mr.
Rigger. Right. Funny, you don't look Italian.
Oh, that's what they say to me all the time.
Okay.
And where am I supposed to go?
Well, let me see. I'll contact the owner. But I'll tell the owner that your name is Mario Satunga.
Hey, that's a good name for me. I think I like that one. Grazie, grazie.
You're welcome.
Mr. Big.
Yeah.
Grazie, grazie.
Right. You got what it takes, dude.